Today, we're taking a look at Capacities. It's a relatively new note-taking application which focuses on object-first note-taking, and it looks quite like Notion. Today, we're going to explore what object-first note-taking is and the pros, the cons, and the features of Capacities to see whether it's right for you as your note-taking application for the future. So welcome, my name is Francesco D'Alessio, welcome to Toolfinder. If you're new to the channel, hit subscribe, but if you're interested in diving into Capacities, you can find it linked up here or down below in the description below to get hold of it. And if you're interested in more note-taking apps in general, you can find the link there just below that too. So Capacities, it's been talked about for quite a while. We actually worked on a course and have a course that digs into it. So I'm very familiar with the application over the last couple of months, and it's super interesting as a software. It's a note-taking application, and at first glances, it looks like Notion. It has a beautifully clean, minimal design, and the primary focus of it is to help you to manage your notes. It's a really good note-taking application because it blends a traditional looking application like Notion or Evernote in terms of its warm approach with a PKM, a personal knowledge management, which allows you to do some of the advanced stuff like graph view, connecting up notes, and block references. And this can all be possible inside of this very interesting application. And I think first, let's talk a little bit about the features, because Capacities offer something interesting. So object-based note-taking is how Capacities creates notes inside of your account. With a traditional note-taking application, you'd add a note and it'd just be created. Maybe you'd add a bit more detail about it. Maybe in Notion, you'd create a database template to help you create a type of note. But in Capacities, you have something called objects, and every time you create a new note, it's associated as an object. So that can be a book, a person, a meeting, or whatever you want. You can create objects in the Object Studio and build them from scratch. And this is really nice because whilst there's a little bit of legwork to get started in creating your objects, you can naturally build out a beautiful structure inside using objects. So aside from that, naturally Capacities allows you to create your notes. It uses a premium feature called Queries, which allows you to narrow down your notes in more detail. This is sort of like a database search or an advanced filter that you can use with tags and search and anything that you've created to narrow down your options. Here's an example I created for a CRM with a few filters included. And as you can imagine, it's helpful for narrowing down those type of notes or objects that you create that are specific to a certain tag, object, or search-based criteria. Now, there are some additional premium features as well, like AI chat, which is a cool way to be able to connect up objects that you create with artificial intelligence. So for example, if you've made a bunch of book notes on the 4-hour work week, for example, you could turn them into a summary or use the AI chat feature to dig a little bit deeper using the context that you have for the object that you've created, which is a really interesting perspective on the concept of objects in your note-taking application. Now, as a whole, there is additional features like the calendar view, which allows you to plan ahead using the calendar abilities. And it's really nice because you get to see a view of what you've created, as well as a plan ahead in terms of your notes and tasks for the day, a little bit like how Daily Notes works. Now, in terms of the pros, a lot of people will like this application because it has that object-based thinking. A little bit like your brain is associating it to things that you're creating across a day and will change your perspective on how you take notes across a day. The application is also very fast and available on desktop and web, and also on the mobile devices as well. And from playing and using it, it was fast and easy to quickly search for things as well as reference things for later. The application is fairly easy to get on with. A lot of people will find it a good balance between PKM and traditional note-taking application, whilst having a beautiful design that a lot of people will find approachable. Some of the cons of this application, I would probably say association to getting started, because for some people, getting started with a brand new system that uses objects can be completely daunting because you've got a lot of legwork to get started on. Now, naturally, Capacities has some importing abilities, which is very helpful, but in terms of getting things rolling in the same system you're doing things now can be a little bit of a stretch, and potentially in the future, exporting these elements might have the same difficulty. Now, Capacities is developed by an independent developer and charges a really reasonable rate for their monthly premium. They also have a free plan which gives you unlimited notes and objects, which is very helpful for getting started. And the application in itself has quite a promising overview in terms of what it offers, which a lot of other applications tend not to have. And the team are fairly fast in how they're developing the application in terms of reaching new markets, but as well as making it really accessible for those who are using it every single day. So who is Capacities best for? Well, I would say it's good because it has a simple nature and design, but it is really advanced when it comes to setting things up with your notes. People will love this if they're struggling with structure with their note-taking application, because objects make things a lot easier to approach with. And the calendar views are fantastic for planning ahead, which a lot of people will like. The application also takes into account things like images and media and bookmarks, which is great for saving for later. But all in all, this application is definitely a shift in thinking. So it's going to be popular with those who like to change the way that they note-take, or maybe make a new note-taking system from a new concept or structure like Capacities has. Now, Capacities isn't the only one with object-based note-taking. Other apps like AnyType are introducing this concept to the market. And Capacities, in my opinion, is probably the most robust way I've seen it being done. Although AnyType have more features in terms of the project management abilities, but naturally, Capacities is a very impressive software that I've seen on the market so far. So if you're interested in checking out a little bit more, we've got a course in it. You can dive into it on Toolfinder, or you can check out other tools that are similar to Capacities linked in the description below. But a big thank you for stopping by in today's video, and hopefully we gave you some insights on Capacities to see whether it's right for you. It's been a delight diving into this application. I hope you guys have a fantastic day. If you want to subscribe to us here on YouTube, you can find that linked below. And as normal, find tools over on Toolfinder. I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio, folks.